Question says, sex is a problem, no doubt. When we think that it's a physical, biological demand, then it's a lust. But is it not necessary to expand the world? Is it not a natural gift to humans to expand? You are saying that sex is a problem when we think that it is a physical, biological demand. It is not a matter of what you think of sex. It is a matter of whether you think of sex. Is sex firstly not a thought for you? Or is it something of the heart? Or is it something natural? You are saying that sex is a problem only when we think that it is a physical, biological demand. What else is it for the majority of human beings? Man lives in demands only. If one's sex is not a physical, biological demand, what else is it? If it is not a physical and biological demand, then it will become a social demand. Then it will become a demand of organized religion. It is nevertheless a demand. It is nevertheless an extraction, the way we have it. You are saying, is it not necessary to expand the world? No, it is not necessary to expand the world. And even if it is, you have not been made responsible to expand the world. Did you determine how the world would be? When you were born, what makes you think that you have been given a responsibility to expand or contract the world? And when I say expand or contract, again please see that you are being selective in just talking of expansion. Why not contraction? In order to hide one's ignorance, in order to give a more respectable and acceptable name to one's basic tendencies, one starts talking of the simple and straightforward things in a convoluted and deceptive way. Man starts saying that he is not having sex to enjoy himself. Instead, he is having sex to fulfill his great duty of procreation. Now there is no shame. Otherwise, man forever lives in guilt and shame. Man says, because he has been taught this way, that sex is something abhorrent. Sex is something animalistic. Sex is something to be avoided. Man is so afraid of his basic animal nature that he turns sex into a monster. But sex is irrepressible. So then he starts searching for excuses to have sex. He says, no, I'm not going towards sex just for my physical or mental needs. I'm going towards sex because it is my divine responsibility to have kids and further the cycles of this world. You are saying, is it not necessary
to expand the world. The only thing that is necessary for you is to understand what this world is, who you are in relation to this world, and whether you really are anybody. That is the only thing necessary. Nothing else is necessary. And when you have met that which is really necessary, everything else is taken care of. Everything else follows. Don't take miscellaneous stuff as necessary. Don't start treating the trivial as central. Realize the ways of the mind. Go close to the ego. Look carefully at the world. That is the only thing that is necessary. And then all your decisions will be wonderful. Mind you that the world knows how to take care of itself. Prakriti was there before you and Prakriti will be there after you. You better not interfere. Your interference is an anomaly. Your interference is a problem. Even without your permission or your contribution or even your understanding, the universe knows out of its own intelligence. Your primary obligation is towards yourself, not towards the world. Because unless you know yourself, you do not know the world. If you do not know the world, how do you know what your obligation is towards the world? If you do not know somebody, do you know your obligation towards that person? Watching is the only way of knowing. Honesty in observation is the only way of knowing. Watch the world and then you will know who we are, what the world is, what sex is, what lust is, what does it mean to have kids.